my good friend from the industry, Sunil Mittal.
My dear friend, Mukesh Ambani.
Bhai Bhai was supposed to be the biggest nara we'd all ever heard, but today at the India Mobile Congress, it changed to Friend Friend. That's the new tagline.
You know, so he's referring, of course, about that great bonhomie today at the India Mobile Congress between Sunil Mittal and Mukesh Ambani, and they kept saying, my dear friend Sunil and my dear friend Mukesh.
My good friend.
I suspect it's partly like when I say my friend Rajiv. You know, it's not entirely dissimilar to that and probably equally accurate. Rajan Matthews is with us as well, the person behind the entire Mobile Congress. And today, for the next half an hour or so, we are going to really show you a glimpse of the future of the mobile industry, because we heard it at stage out here. The two biggest players from an industry point, and Vodafone also came in and spoke. All the ministers involved in this, and of course, industry associations like COAI, all of them were present on one stage. We heard it from them, and because the mobile is as important as it is, it pretty much sums up your future.
May I just say congratulations on everything you've done, but congratulations on having that stage populated with those people. And I cannot even begin to think how difficult it must have been. Like I said, off camera, you've grayed a little.
So, Rajiv, like I said, it's lucky I haven't lost my hair. But I mean, to be factual, the DOT, the Honorable Minister, played a key role, obviously, in sending out those invitations and making sure that Mr. Mittal and Mr. Ambani would be present. Huge support from the minister.
And also, he had the best line of the day.
Sir, as long as you and Mr. Ambani continue to refer to yourselves as friends, I think the industry is okay, sir.
No, I didn't allow you to say it.
So I said, you keep calling one another friends. I said, if you are friends, then the industry is in good hands, as I said.
So let's just dive straight into it. We want to show you what each of these big players had to say and what the government had to say in response. Mukesh Ambani kicked it off, talking a lot about the big technologies that are coming, the seismic tectonic shifts that are taking place, and why he thinks his company and others are well positioned to take advantage of it.
India has leapfrogged from a lowly 155th in mobile broadband penetration to being the world's largest mobile data consuming nation, number one in the world, in just the last 1 year. The pace at which the Indian mobile industry has grown is unparalleled in the world. Friends, I believe that in the next 10 years, the Indian economy will grow from the present $2.5 trillion to over $7 trillion a year and rank among the top three economies in the world. And to make this happen, the Indian telecom and IT industry has to play a foundational role in creating the digital infrastructure. Data is the new oil. India does not need to import it. We have it in superabundance. It will be a new source of value and will create opportunities and prosperity for India and millions of Indians. The Indian mobile market is now overflowing with data. All of us have worked to create a robust digital circulatory system to carry data to each one of our 1.3 billion Indians, including those living in the remotest village. I believe that 4G coverage in India will become larger than 2G coverage within the next 12 months. There is an urgent need to apply the revolutionary powers of digital technologies to India's pressing needs and challenges. Today, I want to submit three must-do tasks for the consideration of both government and our industry to fulfill our Prime Minister's Digital India vision and his New India vision. First, we must explore and implement innovative ideas to generate employment, self-employment, and income generation opportunities for millions of Indian youth. We must foster confidence in the society that new technologies, such as artificial intelligence, robotics, Internet of Things, cloud computing, big data analytics, 3D printing, blockchain, nanotechnology are all enablers of a new wealth of employment and wealth for all. I believe that we must specially tap the potential of these new technologies to transform and create jobs in the rural and agricultural sectors. Second, digital technologies can be a boon for achieving our national priorities for energy security, water security, and resource security. New sources of energy and new models of transportation with unparalleled efficiencies have become possible thanks to the convergence of several technologies. India must embark on the task of connecting everything and everyone via the super internet of things. This will enable 130 crore Indians to collaborate directly with one another and democratizing economic life like never before. Third, our nation's human capital is our greatest asset. Therefore, digitization of education, skill training, and human resource development in a comprehensive manner must be regarded as a precondition for the success of digital India.
Sort of numbers that he is quoting about are the rate at which data consumption is going 10x in a few months. That's staggering, right?
That is staggering, and that's a global phenomenon as well, but accelerated in India because we only have one network, which is the mobile network. At least in other parts of the world, you have landline and you have satellite and you have TV stations that run on cable, all of that. Here, it's all on one network, so we see the spike. So clearly, yes, to your point, 4G clearly has been set as the facto.
And as Mukesh Ambani says, data is the new oil and we don't have to import it.
Yeah, good point. And that's true. Again, that's one of the things is that we are the IT capital of the world. The world comes to us. There's no particular reason that in 4G and 5G, especially now in 5G, we can't take the world by storm in this.
Well, everything that Mukesh Ambani is doing is, of course, raising certain eyebrows in other parts of the industry, not least Airtel, Idea, Vodafone and the others. So, Sunil Mittal did come out and speak also. He referred a bit to some of that competition, but also said there is a need for cooperation. Here's what Sunil Mittal had to say.
We are on the cusp of some very exciting developments in this industry. I would have never imagined just even 5, 7, 8 years back that the shift in technology, the pace in technology will be such that we will be now conjuring images of a very new world that we are all going to live in. The early trailers that are being seen around AI, backed by cloud computing, AR, VR, putting at a doorstep products like robotic surgeries, AI-backed bots in the banks, in the law firms, autonomous cars, managing very complicated nuclear power stations to manufacturing machines, and all are being led by this new innovative wave of digital technology. Some of those were talked by Anandan from Google. You are seeing, when you're going around the globe, fantastic things happening. I think one very important part I'd like to share with you is, wherever in the world I'm going, the attention towards India is very large. I think our generation is fortunate to see some early changes that are being brought by digital technology. But it will really be our next generation which will witness an entirely new world. I can only conjure some images from autonomous cars and arriving at your doorstep to flying cars which will take you from Pragati Maidan to Gurgaon in less than 10 or 11 minutes. I had my first exposure to a flying car in Germany just last month. And these are not sci-fi, you know, imaginations. These are realities that are happening on the ground. AI-based doctors, which will be bots on the other side, will ensure that the people who are in the villages who don't have access to good health care are being attended for their primary care and perhaps some of the tertiary care as well through these bots. Banks, broking communities will all see transformations on their floors where they do trading. It will be all AI-based bots which will be doing the job. There is going to be a massive transformation. And I think our industry is embracing that change. It's getting ready for that change. But I really, truly wish that we would be living into the next generation to see all those changes. But I hope together with friends like Mukesh, we will build something for the future. I'm reminded of William Wordsworth's poem. After the 1789 French Revolution, he mentioned, "Bliss it was to be alive in the dawn, but to be young was very heaven." I wish I was 25, 30 to see what's going to happen in the next 40 years. But I'm sure that we will lay the foundation for those who are going to enjoy in the next generation.
Flying cars and autonomous cars and robotics and AI and everything else. He said it'll all come together now, but the real fruits of this is for the next generation. So that was an interesting thought coming from
and almost saying that I'm almost sad. He quoted poetry and said, I'm sad that I'm not going to be there. But actually, I don't know. Some of the technologies that's coming now, he might be surprised as to how long life is going to be, especially in biotech. But he said, I'm not going to be really around to see the full fruits of this. I think he's being conservative, but who knows?
But, you know, growing up, we used to read science fiction. And we thought, not in my lifetime, right? Yeah. And we're experiencing it. And I think there's a certain acceleration in technology, right? The adoption curve is very steep after a certain inflection point. So he might be around.